Welcome to Session 5 of the Excel 2013 Essential Skills video course. In this session, you'll learn to present your data in a chart. You'll also learn some valuable tricks of the trade to present your data in the most effective way. This 8-minute preview is designed to enable you to quickly review all of the skills you're going to master in Session 5. If you already have some Excel experience, this 8-minute preview may enable you to skip over some or all of the lessons in this session. So, let's start the clock ticking and begin the preview. In the first lesson, you'll learn the three major design decisions you need to consider when creating a chart, and you'll completely understand what the chart type, chart layout, and chart style mean. In the second lesson, you'll take this source data and create this simple chart with just two clicks of the mouse. In the third lesson, you'll move, resize, copy, and delete a chart. You can see that the chart on the left has been copied to the chart on the right. And along the way, we've also changed the chart style. In the fourth lesson, you'll create a chart using the recommended charts feature. This is a brand new feature in Excel 2013. Excel can take the data on a worksheet and recommend several charts to you. We'll then choose one of the recommended charts to show the temperature range in Hawaii. In the fifth lesson, you'll add and remove chart elements. Chart elements are things such as the axis title, axis elements, and legend elements. You'll use the Quick Layout Gallery to quickly add a set of standard elements to a chart. In the sixth lesson, you'll apply a chart style from the Chart Styles Gallery. And then you'll appreciate how chart styles are linked with the current theme. You'll also learn how to apply a different colour set whilst maintaining the integrity of the current theme. In the seventh lesson, you'll manually format a chart title element using the Format Chart Title task pane. In the eighth lesson, you'll use 3D formatting to add a bevel and a shadow to the chart title. In the ninth lesson, you'll take the chart title element and move it to a different position on the chart. You'll then realign it pixel perfect using the Add Chart Element dropdown, and you'll also learn to perfectly position it at the top of the chart. And you'll also learn how to use the Chart Elements flyout menu to perfectly position different chart elements. In the 10th lesson, you'll apply a chart filter. This is another brand new Excel 2013 feature. You'll take a chart showing USA, Europe, and other sales, and then you'll filter out the other sales to only show USA and Europe. In the 11th lesson, you'll begin by creating a chart from a range. You'll then select part of the range to create a chart showing only USA sales. And then you'll create another partial range to show sales for the USA and Europe. In the 12th lesson, you'll apply non-contiguous source data to a chart. You'll take this non-contiguous data to chart sales for the USA and other. And then you'll select this non-contiguous data to only chart total sales. In the 13th lesson, you'll understand data series and categories, and how they relate to charts created from the data. You'll also learn that there are two different views of data series and category, allowing you to chart the same data in two different ways. The 14th lesson introduces the Select Data Source dialog, the most powerful way of adding series and categories to a chart. You'll begin by creating this chart, and then you'll use the Select Data Source dialog to add a total data series. In the 15th lesson, you'll chart non-contiguous data in a different way by hiding rows and columns. In this example, we've created a chart showing USA, Europe, and other sales, but by hiding column C, you're able to also hide European sales on the chart. And you'll also learn how to use the Hidden and Empty Cell Settings dialog. In the 16th lesson, you'll address a common Excel charting problem. When you have numeric data, that's actually a category. In this case, Excel is interpreting the dates as being another data series, so it's showing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 along the bottom of the chart. You'll learn how to tell Excel that this is actually a category to chart the dates correctly. In the 17th lesson, you'll deal with empty data points. Empty data points can make a chart look strange, but this lesson will show you how to join together the data points to make the chart look more attractive. In the 18th lesson, you'll add data labels to a chart. From this chart, you can only approximate each sales figure, but by adding data labels, you can see the precise sales figure. And you'll also learn how to add a data table to the bottom of a chart. In the 19th lesson, you'll add data labels from a range. This is another brand new Excel 2013 feature. Here's a range showing a percentage mark and grade. It's easy to create this chart from the range, but we'd like to add the grades on the top of each of the bars. You can do this using this new feature, and you'll learn how in this lesson. In the 20th lesson, you'll highlight specific data points with colour and annotations. In this example, we want to emphasise the 2005 bar, and we do that by changing its colour and adding a text box and arrow annotation. In the 21st lesson, you'll learn the importance of the y-axis. In this example, the three data points show almost the same value, but they appear to be showing much larger values because of the y-axis. If we change the y-axis so it starts at 0, we get a much more honest depiction of each value. And this lesson also introduces major and minor grid lines. In the 22nd lesson, you'll emphasise data by manipulating a pie chart. You'll create a pie chart from these four companies' sales. You want to emphasise Splendid Supply sales, even though they have the lowest sales volume of the four competitors. So you'll first rotate the pie chart to make the yellow slice look more impressive, and then pull it out of the pie chart to make it look even more impressive. In the 23rd lesson, you'll create a chart with two vertical axes. This is needed when two sets of values, in this case the price and base rate, are of very different magnitudes, resulting in a chart that isn't very useful. By adding a second y-axis, you can create this chart that accurately represents the data. In the 24th lesson, you'll create a combination chart containing two different chart types. You'll take this data, showing the rainfall, high and low temperatures in Hawaii, and you'll create this chart from it. In the 25th lesson, you'll add a trend line to this chart. The trend line shows that the values are on an increasing trend. And you can also forecast where values are likely to be in future years. In the 26th lesson, you'll add a gradient fill to a chart background. You can see that there's an attractive fill here from yellow at the bottom of the chart to white at the top. The 27th lesson will show you how to create your own chart templates. We'll take this chart and then create a template from it, so that the design can be reused in the future. And as with all sessions, at the end of the session, there's an exercise so that you can test the skills that you've learned. And you're now ready to begin Session 5, Charts and Graphics.